हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश लेसन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेसन वी विल रीड यूनिट नंबर 11, द सोर्सरर्स अप्रेंटिस फ्रॉम ऑक्सफोर्ड रीडिंग सर्कल 3. सो यू आर सपोज टू ओपन पेज नंबर 78 एंड रीड दिस स्टोरी विद मी. स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो अबाउट सोर्सरर? What is the meaning of sorcerer? A sorcerer is a person who claims and believes to have magic power. Clear? So we start our reading now. Many years ago, there was a village in a valley. On a high mountain close by, there was a castle. The people of the village had never been to the castle, but they had heard that a sorcerer lived there. One autumn, when the crops were ready for harvest, the villagers woke to find all their fields empty. The crops had disappeared as if by magic. There were no vegetables, fruits, nuts, berries, or grains anywhere. The fields were bare. The farmers were puzzled. The winter was a hard time for all. Somehow the villagers lived on the food they had stored. In the spring, the farmers planted their crops. The plants grew well, and in the autumn they were ready to be harvested. This time the men stood guard over their crops. But one morning they found all their crops were gone. Their fields were bare. "It must be magic," cried the villagers. "What shall we eat this winter?" asked the women, and the frightened and hungry children cried. James, a brave young boy, shouted, "I will find out who has done this." Before anyone could stop him, he started off up the steep mountain. James walked until dusk. Dusk is the state or period of partial darkness between day and night. When he was near the castle, suddenly, a tall man with a long beard appeared on the path. The man was wearing a long, sparkling, shiny coat and carrying a long stick. On his head was a tall, pointed cap. A large black raven was perched on his arm. Raven is a soul, spirit. Perched, rest on something. James was frightened, but he thought, "I must be brave. What will the people of my village think if I run home now?" "There is no food in my village," said James to the tall man. "I'm tired and hungry. Will you give me some food if I work for you?" The sorcerer looked carefully at James. "Work? Eh!" he said, "I do need an apprentice." "Apprentice?" "Trainee, learner." "Follow me." The raven flew to James and perched on his shoulder. The sorcerer led James into the castle. They passed along dark corridors and James saw some doors ajar. Ajar closed. Some rooms were filled with treasures and others with fruit and vegetables. "These must be from our fields," gasped James, to take a quick breath. "Yes," said the raven, "this wicked sorcerer," wicked, evil or morally wrong, "this wicked sorcerer takes everything. If you can learn his secrets, you can save your people. You can also save me. I am a prisoner here." They came to a large hall. In the hall, there was a long table, and on it were bottles and jars, beakers and tubes. Strange colored liquors bubbled and boiled in large pores on the stone floor. James' eyes opened wide. This might be where he works his magic, thought James. Over the next few days, James worked very hard. The sorcerer gave him no free time. He said, "Stir the mixtures in these large pots and make sure the biggest pot is full at all times." So James stirred, mixed and blended. He carried buckets of water all day long and filled the big pot. One day James tried to leave, but suddenly in front of him a wall appeared by magic. His way was blocked. "If I learn the sorcerer's magic spells," said James to himself, "I can leave the castle." The sorcerer used many magic spells, but when James was near, the sorcerer spoke softly. James could never hear what he was saying. One day, James was so tired that he fell asleep behind some large pots in the hall. The sorcerer did not see him. A loud crash woke James. The sorcerer had dropped a jar on the floor. Then James heard him use a magic spell. James was surprised to see a broom fly through the air and sweep up the broken jar. The next day, when the sorcerer was out, James repeated the magic spell. The broom swept the whole hall. James was so pleased. James ordered the broom to fetch water for the pot, and the broom did that too. But the broom did not stop. It carried the buckets of water and swept the floor as it went. Soon the large pot was full and there was water all over the floor. James did not know how to stop the broom. The water was now flowing out of the door and filling the castle. Then the sorcerer returned. He was so angry. He shouted some magic words. The broom stopped fetching water. "Beat him! Beat him!" screamed the sorcerer. Screamed, give a long loud cry. And the broom began to beat James. But James now knew the magic words, so he told the broom to stop. As the sorcerer came near, James said, "Now I know your magic spells. I shall leave the castle." The sorcerer said the magic words and turned into a huge bear. The bear was going to attack James, and he was frightened. Then James repeated the magic words and thought about a snake. In a flash, James turned into a snake. Now he could attack the bear. He hissed and moved close. But when the snake came near, the bear turned into an eagle and swooped down on the snake. Then James turned himself into a cat and attacked the eagle. This battle went on, and all the while the raven sat on the top of a high window and watched. The cat chased the eagle and tore some of its feathers. The eagle flew out of the window and away up into the mountains. James then turned himself back into a boy. "Quick," he said to the raven, "let us get out of here." And he ran down the mountain to his village with the raven following. After that, James was able to use his magic to help the villagers. They never had any trouble from the sorcerer again. Now come to the exercises. A questions. Question number 1. What happened to the crops in the village? Answer. The crops in the village disappeared just before harvest time. Question number 2. Why did James decide to go and where did he end up? Answer. James went to the sorcerer's castle to find out who had taken all the crops and ended up being his apprentice. Question number three. How did James learn the magic spells? Answer. One day, James fell asleep behind some pots. There was a big crash and James woke up. He saw the sorcerer use a magic spell to make a broom fly. Question number four. What are some of the things that happened when James used his spells? Answer. The broom fetched water for the pot and swept the floor, but it kept on filling the pot and soon there was water all over the floor. Question number five. The wizard escapes in the end of the story. Give an alternate ending to the story. Make it interesting. Answer. When James turned into cat and chased the eagle and tore some of its feathers, it fell down. The cat tore its all feathers and ate its flesh. At the end, the eagle was dead. Suddenly, the magic palace turned into a beautiful palace. James became king of the palace. He went to his village and used his magic powers to help the villagers. So they lived happily ever and forever. B. Reference to context. For each of these lines from the story, say who said the words, to whom, and when they were said. Also say what happened next. 1. I will find out who has done this. Answer. James to the villagers. The second time, when all the harvest disappeared, he promises to find the culprit. 2. Beat him. Beat him. Answer. Sorcerer to his magic broom. When he discovered James using a magic spell to make the broom walk, the broom beat James up. 3. Let us get out of here. Answer. James to the robin. When James, as a cat, managed to chase off the sorcerer, James ran towards the village. See, words and meaning. What is the difference between these sets of words? A. Bear, an animal. Bear, empty. B. A jar, slightly open. A jar, a glass container with a wide mouth. C. Days. 24 hours make one day. Days. Unable to think clearly. D. Close. Nearby. Close. Shut. 2. Find the odd one out. A. Winter, summer, spring, weekend, autumn. In A, winter, summer, spring, and autumn are seasons. Weekend is odd one. B. Hill, star, mountain, desert, valley. Hill, mountain, desert, and valley belongs to the ground, belongs to the earth. These are the parts of earth. And stars are in the sky. So these are stars. Star is odd one. C. Bottle, beaker, jar, pot, fork. In C, bottle, beaker, jar, and pot are used for keeping something. They are a type of containers. We can keep something in them. But fork is odd one here. 3. What is the difference between the two words in each set? A. Perch, alight or rest on something. Sit, remain in particular position. B. Sparkle, shine brightly with flashes of light. Shine, give light out a bright. C. Beard. Beard, a growth of hair on the chin and lower cheeks of a man's face. Whiskers, stiff hairs growing on the face of a cat. D. Harvest, the process or period of gathering in crops. gather, collect, assemble, to bring together into a group. E. Disappear, of a person or thing, to go to a place or into a condition where the person or thing cannot be seen. Vanish, disappear suddenly and completely. Thanks for listening. For new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you like my videos, please share and like.